Well, at least I made the cut this time. Hello friends, another store championship down, another decent performance. I'm edging myself closer to the 90th percentile, but it's still not enough to win any cool swag like the Lila playmat, let alone the store champ buy, because there are just too many good players around here. So many in fact that I got to meet them all. It was a very pleasant store championship, I must say. The opportunity to actually float around the top tables for most of the day and get to play against the very best of the best. That was something. And not to mention that I'm able to hold my own against the big boys. I managed to not get swept by anyone over the course of the 6 Swiss rounds. I brought 2 completely different decks from the previous store champ. Siphon Kate is but a one-trick pony and I'm not very good with food codes, so for the final pre-most wanted list SC that I'm going to attend, I played Fast Advance near Earth Hub with Archer as another form of gear check, along with Wizard, which is very much based on Timmy's second place Worlds deck. Contains 3 Stim Hex instead of 2 to apply maximum pressure. Both decks did very well. I was actually very pleased with the way it performed during the Swiss rounds on the day, because unlike with most of my previous tournaments, there was no imbalance. I didn't feel that either of my decks let me down. What really surprised me was that the decks that I was trying to tech against ended up doing the best against me. My Wizard deck was supposed to deal with food codes very efficiently, but it ended up only having a 50% win rate on the day, despite facing 4 out of 6 food codes. And my NEH deck, on the other hand, was supposed to do okay even against Clawed Kate, because this deck relies more on gear checking and taxing clone chips than trying to fast advance past Clawed. Not only did I lose one game to Kate in the Swiss rounds, it also cost me my entire cut, because I faced 2 Clawed Kates in a row in the top 8 cut, and I was not able to get past the sheer speed of Kate's setup time to close out the game before they got all their R&Ds going. So that was a big pity that I had my one chance at the top cut and I blew it. Well, that's history now, so I'll be moving on to a post-most wanted list world and continue to attempt building good decks to try to conquer a future store championship. In the meantime, I have a couple of videos, one of each side, of me practicing Wizard and Archer Near Earth Hub against people on Jinteki.net. I will be uploading these videos in succession over the course of this week. Another announcement I'd like to make, there is a community poll for the best Netrunner videos of the year, and guess what? One of you viewers out there has very kindly nominated one of my videos as part of this poll. So I don't know who you are, but a sincere thank you for doing so. For everyone else, I'm not asking you to vote for me, I'm just saying, vote for me. Nah, I'm just kidding. To be perfectly frank, there are many, many content creators of Netrunner out there, and each one is their own special snowflake, bringing something very unique to the table. I wouldn't be able to rank anyone over the other, but if you have been supporting my channel and you absolutely love what I do and you appreciate the strategic content that I've been delivering very consistently over the past 2 years, I would be deeply grateful for your votes, because this will hopefully expose my videos to a wider segment of the Netrunner community, and that is something that I'm sure more people will appreciate. Well, I won't ramble on any longer. Thanks everyone for your continued support, and once again, I look forward to producing more quality content in the future. Bye everyone, and happy Netrunning!